What's up everyone? Nerdy Noob here, and I have an unboxing video for you. Wine Series Edition! In this video, I'm gonna be unboxing the 2015 December Loot Crate. Now, I actually know the theme to this month, only because everyone keeps talking about it, and the theme is Galaxy. Galaxy? I wonder if it really is Galaxy, because the theme to the 1UP box this month was Galaxy as well, so maybe there's just some copycats or some miscommunication going on there. But I think the theme was Galaxy. I swear many of you guys told me that you got the Galaxy box. Anyways, if you're interested in getting this box, I'll go ahead and put the pricing details in the description below. Oh, it sounds like something good is in here. Hopefully I didn't break it. Once you cut the tape and you open up the box, this is what you're gonna see. Oh, I like the shirt already. I don't know what, the box, they always have like the special boxes where you can turn them inside out. I don't do all that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Okay, well, this is a very to the point box, right? I see two items, and I think there's something in here. So, the first item we have, it says United Nations Space Command. Oh, it's a Halo 5 product. This is like one of those lunchbox things. I got one that was, Ghostbusters theme, and it had a Slimer plushie in it. Oh my gosh, this is so funny. Okay, wait, sorry. So the first one that we got is Han Solo in his snow gear. It's a Funko Pop. This is cool. There's six different ones that you can collect. He's on his little stand. I like that because then they can actually stand up. Because sometimes when they don't have the stand, they don't stand up by themselves. It's kind of annoying. The next item that we got is a Galaxy Quest emblem patch. Last time I made a comment, like, who uses patches? What would you patch this to? Like, your shirt? And someone said backpack, which totally makes sense. Although, I feel like I haven't seen many people with patches lately. And then the last item in this little thing is, and I feel terrible because Sorn, my friend Sorn, I think I showed you guys, he got me these Star Wars socks because he knows I like the BB-8. So he got me these BB-8 socks because I like BB-8. And the next item in this box is BB-8 Star Wars socks. How funny is that? I didn't think I would get these in a box. Are these the same? So these are Loot Crate exclusives from, not from BioWorld. I almost said BioWorld. Nope, they're from HYP. These are the exact same socks. Now, he got these at Ross for probably cheap because, you know, Ross. And these actually came with two pairs of socks. They had a gray pair that said Star Wars, but I already took those off. So it's just the one pair. So these ones are just packaged by themselves. And they're literally the exact same socks. I don't know how much Sorn paid for those socks. It's too late to call him. I can't imagine he paid more than $10. I probably like $6. How much do socks cost at Ross? I think like $6. But that one had two pairs, so it probably would be a little bit more. Anyways, these are the BB-8 socks, and I like these a lot. We have our Loot Crate pin. It's, I should call these buttons, because they're more like buttons. It's Galaxy, December 2015. And then, again, here's your Halo lunchbox thing. It's very interesting that they were able to fit a Funko Pop in here, because I mean, it makes sense, but then when you're just looking at everything, it doesn't seem like it would fit, but it does. And then, before we do the card, oh, you have your little Loot Crate magazine thing, and then your shirt, which is a navy blue. This is a men's medium. This is, I think, the softy. Yeah, this is a Gildan softy. This shirt's very soft, very nice. I like the feel of this shirt. And then this is, it's like an ugly sweater themed shirt. I don't actually know what the design of this is. Oh. See, these shirts are so, when you're staring at them up close, because they're like the 8-bit design, they're very difficult to kind of read, but you can actually look at the viewfinder. There's some kind of spaceship with a snowman here, and there's another, what is that, like a satellite? A space station? I don't know. But I do like the feel of the shirt. Alright, let's look through the magazine and see what we got. Loot Crate's coming out with new boxes. They have their anime box and their pet box. I was going to get the pet box, but it seems a lot more geared to dogs, not necessarily cats. And I have two cats and no dogs, so I don't know what this... They always have random things in this magazine. So we had our pin. We had our... Oh, it's an exclusive Star Wars Han Solo vinyl bobble. Oh, it's a bobblehead. I didn't realize it was a bobblehead. So apparently this is exclusive. Oh, it's exclusive because he's in snow gear, and the regular one has just his regular outfit. It does have the Loot Crate exclusive sticker. The shirt is an exclusive ugly holiday sweater t-shirt. NASA's New Horizons spacecraft flew within 8,000 miles of Pluto. Historical space vehicles. So it's something to have to do with space stuff. Then you had your Galaxy patch and your BB-8 socks. It says exclusive. So I've always asked, like, are these really exclusive? So here's my question. I have a pair of these because my friend Soren got them from Ross. Does it make these exclusive because there's only one pair of socks? Because the ones that he got me came with two pairs of socks, and these ones just came with one. So is that why it's exclusive? They put their own tag on it, because this is the tag that came on the ones that my friend got me, and this is the one that came on the one in the box. So I would like to know what the term exclusive actually means in this sense. Anyways, and we also got the Halo 5 ammo tin box. Oh, and we got the Guardians Rec Pack. Oh, that was this thing. And there's some kind of code on the back. I don't know what that means. I don't play Halo. I'll give this to T. I think she has this game. All right, that was your 2015 December Loot Crate box with the theme of Galaxy. Price value-wise, $10, $10. We'll say $5 because they usually give socks $5. That's $25, $26, $27. I'm confused. $27, we'll say $6 for this. $27, $28, $29, $30, $31, $32, $33. I don't know what this is for, but we'll say $35. I'm sure that's worth more. So $35, box is about $20 a month. I think I'm getting a little bit cheaper because I have a year-long subscription, so value is there. Items. Well, I like the socks, although I already have them. The shirt's cool, and I like the pop, the Funko Pop. Now, the Funko Pop, I would have actually been happier if they would have... Actually, I don't really know. Honestly, what I was going to say was if they had done the series that I got from my Black Friday haul, only because I'm still missing the Stormtrooper and the First Order Stormtrooper, so I was, you know, hoping maybe they would come with that, but it didn't. I haven't seen the new movie, so I don't know if these are... These are old school, although this looks like the new one. Oh no, this is new. I think this is, so I'm kind of confused because I got the whole series of Funko Pops from the new movie, The Force Awakens. I got that for my Black Friday haul, but I'm pretty sure that this is from the new movie because, you know, first of all, well, he looks really old, and second of all, it says snow gear, and I feel like the new movie, I haven't seen it yet, has all the, like, you know, snow troopers and flame troopers and all this stuff. You could have gotten Princess Leia, Admiral Akbar, Nian, Nub, Sidon, Ithano, and Varmic. But I'm confused because I thought the series that I got was for the new movie, and maybe they just have another series for the new movie, which sucks because I thought I got almost the whole collection except for that Stormtrooper. Either way, maybe just more things for me to collect and waste my money on. If I had to rate this box, I would give this box a... It wasn't a bad box, and it had... You know, it had its value, so I think it could have had more value. I don't remember how much value it was. Oh, it was like in the $30 range. I give this box a 4 out of 5 noobs. My rating system, again, is not really that serious, so don't take it that seriously. But I'd give this a 4 out of 5 noobs. I don't really like this. And this is kind of a big item in this box, so this box is okay. Maybe a 4.25 out of 5 noobs. I don't know. Who knows? All right. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, feel free to click the like button below. If you want to see more unboxing videos, go ahead and check out my channel. I have a whole bunch on there, and you should subscribe. I don't know what's happening, but ever since I hit 1,000 subscribers, actually, ever since I posted that Star Wars Loot Crate exclusive crate, oh, it's like echoing right here. My subscribers just, it's been crazy. They just skyrocket. I used to get like 3 subscribers a day, and it's been like 40 subscribers a day. I do post videos quite often, and I have all of these boxes that I need to unbox, so there should be more videos on the way. So definitely subscribe, that way you get notifications. Let me know in the comment section below what you thought about this box. I know there's a lot of you that are subscribed to Loot Crate, so what did you think about it? Because remember, for a while they didn't have a shirt, and then they weren't really giving us good items, so we got a Funko Pop in this box, we got cool BB-8 socks. What did you guys think? If you had to rate this box out of 5, noobs, what would you give it? No one ever plays along with that. I think I've had one person do it. Tell me, what would you rate this box? 5 noobs, what would you give it? Is 4 low? I'm a stickler. I don't usually give anything 5s, and even in the 4 range to me is like, no, you have to be really good to get that. But this was a good box. I just don't like this Halo lunchbox thing. It's kind of random. I think they probably got sponsored by Halo because they have some kind of download thing too. So maybe that's just like a sponsorship deal. Who knows? Alright, remember, if you are subscribed to my channel and your subscriptions are not blocked or set to private, you will make it onto my thank you to subscribers page, which is coming up right now. Have a great night, you guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Bye!